Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2.
Cool.
I'm back playing Metro. Hopefully, things will go better than yesterday. But I have to complete this tonight. And then, last light, tonight. / tomorrow morning. But I have a cunning plan, you see. As Baldric once said, I've got a cunning plan, sir. Indeed I do. Indeed I do. It's lagging a lot. I think how I'm gonna deal with Exodus is I'm gonna stream it and record it and boot the recordings up to YouTube, because it will be way better. It's not just me, right, but there's like a person sitting on a person standing or something. Or two people standing. In the reflection. It's fucking weird. As bows. Oh shit. Oh, God damn it. I heard him say alarm. I'm like, fuck.
So we'll have to sit in the dark.
Now I'm going to go back up and climb back down the ladder rather than faff about with going through that door. Oh fuck. This is bad. Ouch. Waiting for him to get to that side. Then I can put him down. Going to start walking down here? Maybe. I don't know.
the second ship coming or what? Shoot to the bone. The filter's almost done for, too. My watch shows us at least 10 more minutes. I wish I were somewhere. This place gives me the shivers.
Very nearly almost didn't make that. Doing so well. need him to come this way. Here he comes. Oh, look at that lens flare off the moon. I guess that's the moon. It might be the sun though. I don't know. What? God fucking damn it. Right. So I'm gonna deal with that first. He didn't even attempt to grab the ladder.
Off here. Now help! Hold up there!
Now I can get that bloody key. As soon as he fucks off. Come on, pick it up! Fuck's sake! Managed to clear the fucking floor and then got picked up because I couldn't get the key. Why? At least I've got a bit of a strategy now. Somewhat. Don't turn the light off, just kill him. Come on. Make so much noise when you die, goddammit. I'm trying to be stealthy. Here he comes. Now it's the reflection of a tunnel. That could have been bad if he'd noticed that my first knife missed. Fly through the window. If it did, that would be bloody amazing. Nope, it landed there. If it had flown through the window, that would have been funny, to be honest. Need him to go back over by the window. So I can turn off this light, and then I'm a lot less likely to be spotted.
Maybe nothing. But hey, seems like someone. Shit, I have to check this out. Let it drag.
Except you didn't actually check out shit, mate. It's an extra filter. That's a throwing knife.
Shit. Is the second ship coming or what? Chill to the bone. The filter's almost done for, too.
It's a shame this game doesn't have some sort of manual save system. But then again, people like me would just abuse the ever-loving shit out of it. Never pay to be too stealthy. You can pay not being stealthy enough, and you can pay for being overzealous.
Hey.
Well, it's kind of noisy. Well, it was just my imagination after all.
Could have been real fucking bad. Looking a funny way.
The dim place gives me goosebumps.
Take that one out. Then the one by the fire, I think. Ambler, AK, used a gun. Bastard gun. Clear. just flag station.
The station was occupied by fascists. But Olin had said he'd wait for me there. I had to risk it.
Let's get into black.
Who is it? Surrender and you won't get hurt. I swear.
Yeah.
What took you so long? Where's Pavel? Did he... All right. Later. The situation got worse. Nazis literally flooded the station. He'll have to act alone. Sorry. But if you can shut down their generator, it'll be easier to sneak past the guards. Take this. I will wait for you in the deserted tunnel to Polis.
Right.
All that.
Uh-huh. And who is gonna feed your children, huh? Sturmbannführer, perhaps?
What the life. Maybe get their families and go to Ganza?
You know what happened to those who tried.
Bastards.
Him I want to take down. Him I want to knock out. God fucking damn it. Immediately. Fuck's sake.
What took you so long? Where's Pavel? Did he... All right. Later. The situation got worse. Nazis literally flooded the station. He'll have to act alone. Sorry. But if you can shut down their generator, it'll be easier to sneak past the guards. Take this. I will wait for you in the deserted tunnel to Polis.
How's your family?
They missed their father. Yours?
I don't know. I haven't seen them for weeks. And now we're stuck here.
Yeah.
needs all that?
Uh-huh. And who is gonna feed your children, huh? Sturmbannführer, perhaps?
What the life? Maybe get their families and go to Ganza?
You know what happened to those who tried.
Bastards.
Oh, some rest would do me good.
Hey, it's the damn dress.
Kitchen's cold, stupid imagination. Wrong.
Sleep tight. And you too. We all wear impenetrable armor, even after taking off one vest or all the clothes altogether. One still stays clad in head to toe. We are terrified of opening up to people, sharing our feelings, afraid of someone understanding our thoughts. We hide our faces wearing gas masks. But there's one more mask beneath that one. Ullman, the indomitable optimist, the light-hearted jester. I had only seen his real face when his comrade died. Tired to death, almost desperate. That's how he looked. For only a second. A moment later, he had his armor back. His regular funny self again? I didn't try to get him to open up again. It's not the Metro way, and I'm certainly not opening up for anyone myself. True. Wasn't expecting him to turn around. Was not paying attention, was I? Alright, so I can take him out down there. Thank you. Yes, I prefer taking lights out without breaking them. Because Archom understands that light bulbs are a finite resource. Yes.
Jeez, what the hell is that?
Who goes there?
These are my ears.
Fuck. That was my fault again.
Okay, as long as no one touches it. Damn shaky piece of junk.
Put a guard on it.
Toha, Kozoi, come here. Watch the generator. And if I catch you playing cards, you're dead, man.
That was almost a disaster. someone's little reading nook. Got an AK-2012. Nice. Yes, the AK-2012 is based off of not the real world AK-2012, because at the time of the creation of these games, it didn't exist.
Sinking in shit, but not us. Why? Because we have order. And if we don't force our will on every station down the line, it's fucking doomsday. Don't you feel pity for people? It's too late for pity. Get your
keep story. Him alive. Kill him.
Hey, what the hell?
That's a bit close to that, I think.
Well,
it's just my imagination. Getting cold definitely seems a possibility now.
Some sleep would be great.
He's the one I want to keep alive.
Shit. Oh, I called him. Oh, this is just grim.
Okay.
Hey.
What the
hell?
Hey, what the hell was that?
Looks like there's...
Go turn off the lights and make their lives way harder.
Join the army at the right time. Heard they tighten standards again.
Lucky. I'd love to get myself a gummy. And find out what those pigs are plotting with prejudice. Hey?
Got him. Eventually. If at first you don't succeed, Try again. Let's see what's at the other end of these stairs. This is where Ullman was. So I guess we know who killed all the Nazis in the tunnel.
Something happened, and the gate to Metro 2 was shut down forever. Those living here forgot about Metro 2, and it became a thing of myth. But though we are no longer aware of Metro 2, it does exist. It is all around us. Its tunnels entwined with our own. Its stations behind the walls of our stations. The two metros are inseparable. And those who believe that the shepherds could not abandon their herd say that they watch over us still. Directing our every step, but do not show themselves to us. And that is what faith of the invisible watchers is.
But why they do not wish people to know about them?
First of all, sheep are sick, for they turned down their shepherds in a time of weakness. And ever since Metro 2 was separated from our world, the shepherds have evolved in a different way. They are no longer human, but creatures of a higher order. Whose logic is not understandable for us. They have the power to change everything, even to return the lost beautiful world of us. But because we rebelled against them, they do not take part in our destiny anymore. However, they exist everywhere and are all-knowing and all-seeing. Only after we repent our sins will they reveal themselves and offer their help. And salvation will come. That's what is said by the people who believe in the Invisible Watchers.
Interesting legend.
Sounds an awful lot like the Dark Ones. Metro kills the belief in miracles, but teaches you to live without hope. And still, I can't find any explanation for me being able to successfully negotiate the labyrinth of the Black Station, full of Nazis, mind you, short of a miracle, as if I was led by someone. Was it my stupid undying hope, or perhaps fate itself? Who knows, Artyom? Who knows? Oh yeah.
We'll reach Polis soon.
These are not the usual mutant creatures. This is something else. Something much worse.
Fuck you, Khan!
It's hard to describe my feelings at that moment. Exhausted, yes, but joyful. I had made it. Once I delivered Hunter's message, the rescue of my home station would be decided by those stronger and wiser than I. And my task would be over.
To take your station.
Ullman, is that you? You're lucky Petrovich isn't here. He's not a man for jokes. Who's that with you?
He's from the northern frontier. I'm escorting him from the Black Station.
All right, come on through.
God damn, do I love the Rangers. Pillbox on them. Big pillbox. Polis. That's a lot of wood. Kind of holding cell.
All right, let's go.
Move it!
Welcome to Polis, Captain Krasnov. You've come a long way, young man. Where exactly are you from?
He's from the exhibition.
What, can't he speak for himself?
Look, Cap, it's the kid's first time in Polis. He's been through hell getting here, and he's carrying Hunter's message to Miller. So, cut him some slack, huh?
All right, get changed. There's the clothes. You can leave your gear. It'll be safe here. You'll get it back sparkling clean.
You go ahead and take some rest, Artyom, and I'll go find Miller. I hope he's not out on a mission.
By the way, don't forget to scrub yourself down in the lobby, old man.
I won't. You pain in the ass.
Would you rather have two-headed kids? Idiot.
For as long as I really remember myself, I always had a dream of visiting Polis. The hard and hopeless life underground wears men down, makes him a savage, a beast, and only in Polis does he manage to keep a resemblance to the great people of the past, the ones who had the planet in their pocket. Polis is the last refuge of the scientists, the educators, the artists, everyone who'd be deemed useless by the other stations, the last citadel of culture and civilization. And stories told in the metro insist that electric lights were on there day and night, though. Just like it used to be in our past, that's never to return. Polis did deliver on all the outrageous expectations I had. Vast, shining, clean to perfection, a real underground city, its four stations united into one rhythm. With the halls of the ancient temples I saw in history books, by just being here, you start to feel this incredible energy, start to believe that humanity will once more rise from its knees. If there is a force in the metro capable of saving the exhibition from the Dark Ones, it must reside here.
Hello! Bullets exchange! And where is your ammo? Mine's here. You don't have that caliber.
Bullet.
And where is your ammo? Mine's here.
But pa!
Don't pa me.
You won't find any sharp.
And by the way, the Nazis did finally entrench there.
You can't.
I accidentally sold some ammo that I didn't want to. Bagger!
Yes?
Welcome to Polis, Captain.
You won't find better rates in the whole
come
metro.
A long way, young man. Where exactly are you from?
He's from the exhibition.
What? Can't he speak for himself?
And where is your ammo? Cap. Mine's
it's
here.
It's first time in Polis. He's been through hell getting here, and he's carrying Hunter's message to Miller. So, cut him some slack, huh?
All right. Get changed. There's the clothes.
Make sure you can count
gear
to five.
It'll be safe here.
Close your
we'll
target to pieces. Bang! And problems
take some rest,
Artyom,
and I'll go find Miller. I hope he's not out on a mission.
By the way,
a cure for
don't
everything.
Forget to scrub yourself down in the lobby, old man.
I won't.
Always
I won't.
Good deal.
You pain in the ass.
Would you
rather have two-headed kids? Idiot.
Hello!
I wanna go pee!
Too late. Now you have to wait.
But pa!
Don't paw me.
As you wish. Whatever.
Then I was waiting for them at the block station. Oh, and by the way, the Nazis did
come, look, try and buy.
They're definitely creeping closer to us.
Mm-hmm.
What is he?
Bullets exchange! No, you will find better race in the whole metro!
Artyom, I'm Neil. Where is the message from Hunter?
This way.
Well, thank you for bringing this to Polis. Was a brave thing you did. I'll call an emergency session. When they summon you, you'll report the situation. All council members, please assemble in the council chamber. I repeat, all council members, please proceed to the council chamber. Escort the boy to the council chamber.
Look, man, why the fuck do you always drink so much?
I had to.
Do you?
Fuck. That's that, unusual. Man.
As if you have nothing new face. Better to do.
Hello?
Fuck.
Get lost. I'm not in the mood.
Yeah, right. And every time you get pissed drunk, I end up carrying you. I sure as hell could do better.
Sorry, man.
Well, once, me and the boys were having a drink. Well, a few drinks. Lots of drinks. Shit, we were plastered.
You're always plastered.
Anyways, so we had a few but wanted more.
What? Oh. What do you want?
You weren't saturated by then?
Hell no. Sorry, man. Did I interrupt you?
Sorry, bro. Go on.
This is funny.
Yeah. So, we went to have another.
I'm gonna go get a drink whilst you listen.
We're in a fucking tunnel. What the hell? Fuck if I know. 1 minute we're leaving the bar and somebody stepped on my hand. Then, we're in the tunnel. Dark as shit.
So?
So we just looking around, and then we see them sneaking along the wall. Them? What do you mean, them? Like, not us. So we jump up. It's a caravan. And the caravan was some real tough bastards. We barely got the best of them. And after all that, the fuckers are broke. So we decide to sell them to slavers, make some dough.
So, what then?
So we get them to the station, and we see that they were Spiri and Plotnik. Both of them so wasted they couldn't talk. Then we had a laugh. Yeah, well, listen to this. Spiri says they were attacked in the tunnels and beat the other guy's asses. That the attackers ran like squirrels.
Fuck you guys. I can't laugh anymore. I'm gonna burst.
Drunk people.
Stop bothering me.
Wait a bit.
You can't go in there. It's a high danger zone.
Is going to roast it.
They're literally experimenting. They're trying to learn what makes an osalysis by cutting it open. Boom.
I'm stunned that the council has refused to help your station. I'm ashamed that they lack the courage you have already shown. But Polis is not the whole metro. There still are people who will rise up and fight the threat of the Dark Ones. Okay. Listen carefully. The Rangers have found several well-preserved missile bases near the city. Some could probably be activated and deliver a missile strike against the Dark Ones. The problem is that the missiles are supposed to be launched from the command center, D6, but we don't know where that is or if it's operational. However, we do know where that information can be found. There's a huge library on the surface, dangerous place, but it contains a secret military archive. We must go there. Okay, we'll split up now to avoid attention. You'll go up from here. I've already arranged that. When you've made your way to the library entrance, I'll be there waiting for you. Okay? Hey, Artyom. Be careful. Ah, one more thing. When we go back, we'll head straight for Sparta Base. My rangers will meet us there.
Who said that stupid and pompous phrase about responsibility coming with power? I thought that Polis was the pinnacle of all power in the Metro. Its guards armed to the tooth. Its incredible reputation among any factions and stations. Its stores of food and ammunition. Its wealth and prosperity. Polis is the hub of the universe. But apparently, this hub does not care one bit for some backwater station. The council didn't even want to waste time hearing us out, but after reluctantly agreeing to do so, it just lazily stamped declined on the desperate plea for the exhibition. And it wasn't just my request that they declined. They did it to Miller, the head of the Rangers. I thought it was all over. If not for Miller and his people, the Rangers are not called an order for nothing. There are a veritable knightly order, a state within a state, a brotherhood of people sworn to oaths, adherence to which they value higher than their lives. And the Rangers are sworn to protect the Metro from all the dangers threatening its dwellers, no matter the station they live at or what they believe in.
Let's go!
The council's decision shocked me, but Miller's plan gave me hope. Once more, I climbed up to the bones of Moscow to search for the secret of D6 and a way to awaken the horde of missiles.
The Rangers call their base Sparta, and themselves, either jokingly or seriously, Spartans. They do fit the part, mind you, ready to die rather than surrender. They are also few, just like their historical counterparts. Counterparts, not parts. Each of them is a seasoned fighter, worth 10 regular soldiers, but they just don't have the manpower to fight a full-blown war, or stand against the legions of the Darked Ones. That is why Miller's plan is our only chance. Find a still-operational missile launch site, command the missiles, and burn the Darked Ones' nests to cinders. If we pull it off, our casualties should be minimal, while my home station and the whole Metro with it saved. Seems like the perfect plan, but something is worrying me. There seems to be a weak spot in it. Something's not right. I can't shake the feeling that we're making a mistake. Ooh.
Thank you.
Ow. Oh, God damn it. Thank you. I want to check something real quick. Fuck. Yeah. Thought so. Because there's a stash in one of those trucks that I can't get now. I can't get back up. Oh well. Nope. Nope. I'm restarting the mission. Fuck it.
The council's decision shocked me. But Miller's.
Thank you. from Amazon. Yay! Exodus is officially on its way. So it will be arriving tomorrow. That's awesome. Ah, fuck. Here they come. Thank the fuck you've turned up!
Fucking hell.
You're a bit bloody late!
You're here, that's good. You're worried. You remember what to do?
We need to go to the military archives. It is somewhere beneath the main library. Now, we can reach it through the main breathing hole, alright? Enough freezing here. Let's go.
I need to find some ammo, if at all possible. I have just used a lot. Yes. I indeed have used a lot. So far, the VSV has been doing all right.
Anyway, watch the outside. We'll go with our temperature over here. Seems to be quiet.
Guys, a flock of birds came to see us!
I read and reread all the books we had at the station, till they fell apart. I always rushed to the traders coming home from the far stations to be the first to try and barter for a few greasy tomes. They could have... For the few greasy tomes they could have brought. Even though nobody else would ever want them, let him hear, I read anything. When you live 60 meters underground, books become your only windows. I worshipped books. So try and imagine my feelings at the sight of the Great Library. The shrine to all the important books ever written in human history. But I must not forget the reason that brought me to this place. If I let myself get distracted, start browsing these half-rotted, mouldy tomes, the library will swallow me up whole and forever. Damn. I just saw that lurker. Ouch. I hate lurkers.
Don't go anywhere. We'll come for you on our way back. It's joke. Any longer, and those beasts would have ripped us apart. One word or two.
Gonna kill it. Just pissing it off.
Who cares? In the gas mask, we won't smell it anymore.
Very much is. I've read Roadside Picnic. It is a good book. That thing is tricked out. Scope on it. Yeah, nah, I'll stick with this for a minute. Not the only one that heard that, right? Now, once we get into the basement of the library, that's when I'm going to finish. And I'm going to go get the stuff. Because it is coming up to 7:30.
You probably read about it in the books of the saints. It must have been beautiful. Listen, Artyom. Librarians are some of the most dangerous creatures out here. If you meet one, or do God forbid, don't fight it. But don't run from it either. The beasts won't attack you if you look them in the eye. Now remember, never let them out of your sight. Show them your back, you'll die. Okay, if a beast gets nervous, move away, but slowly. And if you shoot, well, look or don't look, you won't see anything ever again.
Watch it,
Okay, he's still alive. Okay, I must get him to Polis. You'll have to find the map yourself. Here are the floor plans. The entrance to the military archive is somewhere on the first floor of the library. The door the librarian went through leads there. There's not much time. Dawn's coming. Go now, and remember what I told you about the beast, okay? I'll try to come back as soon as possible. Go.
Is that demon actually dead? I have no idea. I don't think so. Why did I use a throwing knife? God damn it, I'm an idiot.
I was alone again. And soon I would look into the eyes of fear, literally.
I love the librarians. But we'll save that for next time. I'm gonna go grab some food, go get some stuff, because tonight's gonna be a bloody long one. Right, I'll see you in a bit. Well, yeah. Right. See you in a bit.